in person. I sense so strongly there will be a personal, divine visitation of the Lamb of God, the Lord Jesus Christ, to the revival.
Finish it, Lord. Bam, 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 bam. Do it, Jesus. A brand new hip. Bam, 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 bam. God, I command polio, polio, polio. I just command healing in that leg. Can you feel that? Polio, polio, polio.
I was in a meeting one time in Hope, BC, Canada, small church, 50 people. And I was just about to go out of the service, and an old lady comes running into the meeting. And I mean, not running, but kind of limping it. The reason she was in such a hurry was it was 11 o'clock at night and she wanted to be healed. She needed a hip replacement or something in her hip. And this woman said, "Please, Mr. Bentley, we're at the back door on the way out of the venue." She said, "Can you please pray for me?" And I said, "You remind me of my Nana. Of course I'll pray for you. You're so sweet." And I went to lay hands on her. "Oh God, I pray for this woman to be healed." And just as I did, I heard the Lord say, "Slap her in the face." I said, "God." He said, "Do it now." There was a door about 6 feet away, shut and locked. I hit the woman in the face. Bam! Power of God hit her so hard, she blew back 6 feet off the ground, hit the door, blew the door off the hinges, slid across the floor into the kitchen where women were preparing, you know, the potluck snack after the meeting. And the woman came sliding all the way into the kitchen and got up totally healed. You know, the Lord is telling me something right now. You want this anointing?
Yes!
You ready?
From God.
Lord, I pray right now that this holy knee
Hey Todd, check this out. She had an issue of blood. You called it out.
Boom, bam, 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 bam. Bam. I've prayed for like 100 crippled people, not one. He said, "That's because I want you to grab that lady's crippled legs and bang them up and down on the platform like a baseball bat." And I started going, "Be healed! Be healed!" I started banging them up and down on the platform. She got healed. And I'm thinking, "God, why is not the power of God moving?" He said, "Because you haven't kicked that woman in the face." And there's this older lady worshiping right in front of the platform. And the Holy Spirit spoke to me. The gift of faith came on me. He said, "Kick her in the face with your biker boot." I inched closer and I went like this. Bam! And just as my boot made contact with her nose, she fell under the power of God.
Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus.
It's on your daughter still.
Oh, yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Woo, the healing's in the house. Woo, yes.
Bam, 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 bam. People always ask me about the bam, bam. In fact, I was on the internet and I was amazed how many people are criticizing the revival in Lakeland. I said, what? People are getting saved, healed, millions are hearing the gospel. And the one thing that people just can't get over is the bam. I said, really? Well, I'm sorry, but it's about the fruit. And I tell you what, I asked the Lord one time why I go bam, bam, bam. He said, dunamis. You know the word for power is dunamis? Dynamo, dynamite, explosive power like dynamite. There's something about, it comes out of my gut. I don't just decide. People think I just do it. Why does he say bam? It's a manifestation. It's not something I do. It's something that comes out of my belly. And when it happens, power, power, power. Bam, bam, bam. Power, power, power. Bam, bam, bam. There's something there. Yeah, there you go. We're going to write a song. Bam, bam, bam. Power, power, power. Bam, bam, bam.
Power, power, power. Power, power, power.
What happened here? Lord, NASA, it's all about Jesus, and I'm preaching on the cross and the resurrection. Enough for all that. I've got to stop holding back and denying the testimony of the supernatural. And I was in a meeting. It was about 11 o'clock at night. Everybody was just about gone home. And this little sweet old lady, you know, 70 something years old, comes in and she's just sweet as grandma pie. And she knew I was tired and the meeting was over and she was standing in the back of the church. They had the door shut and locked into the kitchen. She's standing in the hallway and she says, man of God, do you have anything left? Can you just pray for me, please? And I thought, oh, this sweet little grandma needs prayer. I'm going to pray for grandma. And so I lifted my hand up and I laid hands on her and prayed for her. And the Lord said, no, I want to touch her right now. She needed to be healed, some kind of chronic arthritis or something. The Lord said, I want you to slap her in the face. I said, God, you want me to slap grandma in the face? He said, that's right. Just slap her in the face. So I took my hand and I went, bam! And I just slapped her across the face. Literally, she was picked up off of the ground, flew back several feet, hit the door so hard she blew the door off the hinges and slid on her back into the kitchen, laying on the floor. People were preparing a meal for potluck Sunday. And she went right through the door, blew the hinges, splintered the door right off, and grandma went sliding across the floor, got up totally healed by the power of God.